Renegade Health Show, and today is Friday. We are spending a nice, relaxing day. Kind of relaxing. I mean, we're still working, right, Ann? Nice, relaxing day here in Key West. And if you just take a look over here, Emery will show you. Well, not that.
What?
But we got to know this thing here.
Oh.
Yeah. No, you don't need to look at it. No. I want you to show over there. No one wants to see that thing. I don't even know what that is.
I don't know.
Show over there.
That's what I was doing. And then you sat over here.
Oh,
I'm showing them the boats.
Showing you the boats. Beautiful. The water's really nice. Everything's cool. We do want to show you, when we first were coming down to Key West, we figured we'd search raw food restaurants. And we found this place here. It's called Eat It Raw.
Eat It Raw.
But it has nothing to do with with vegetables. This actually, they have oysters here, but that doesn't even look like oysters. I don't even know what that white stuff is. Maybe scallops, who knows. Anyway, I want to answer some of your questions here. First off, Carol asks, how can you trust the FDA standards when you know you're taking your medical tests? And this is a great question, because what they do with the medical tests is they take a whole group of people, and then they take the average, and this is where they come up with their sample testing, and this is where they come up with their numbers in terms of what their highs and their lows are. So obviously that's not going to be the best protocol. So testing is really not going to be as valuable if you just do one test. What you have to do is you have to do a string of tests over a period of time, for an extended period of time, for maybe even the rest of your life. And what you can do with those tests is then you can see trending and decide if something's going up or going down. So it's a really important question. But what I do want to say is that do know that the vitamin D recommendations are based on, particularly the recommended daily allowance, are actually much higher than the FDA standards. So this has been established with a lot of good research recently on vitamin D. All right, so Jameson asks, Marshall Protocol, can you contact Trevor Marshall and get him for an interview? Of course we can. We can see what's going on. One thing about the Marshall Protocol, I've talked about the Marshall Protocol on previous shows, but one thing about the Marshall Protocol is that he's recommending the use of a lot of different pharmaceuticals to help modulate the immune system. I think we can do it with other things, so I don't know exactly how in-depth the Marshall Protocol is, but I'm going to ask him if we get him on an interview. All right, let's see. So SC says you are very good friends with David Wolf, and he advocates the use of cacao as much as you want. What do you think about that, and how does it affect your friendship? Well, it doesn't affect our friendship, because everyone has different opinions on a lot of different things. So when it comes to cacao, I just simply don't agree. When it comes to other things, I completely agree. So you can't look at someone in their theories as black and white. So if you disagree with something, you disagree with everything, because then you'd be a pretty lonely guy or gal. And so when it comes to this, we still need to come to a common ground. And the reality is that 90 to 95 to 99% of what David and I believe is just about the same. And same with Doug Graham. When it comes to eating, fruits and vegetables, look, this is where we need to be. And the rest of the stuff, it's a very small percentage of other stuff that is, kind of thrown back and forth as like the controversy. But if you look at everyone's theory, the reality is that 90, 95% of everyone agrees on everything, which is eat more fresh fruits and vegetables. Let's see. Ann started taking vitamin D, does not notice a difference. How long does it take? In this case, you might not notice a difference. What you want to do is you want to check your blood test again and see if that's increased. When it comes to supplements, sometimes you're not going to find a difference, because what happens is that over time, the deficiencies actually may turn into disease. It doesn't mean that if you take the supplement right now, you're going to feel a difference. Supplements where you will feel a difference right away, if you are really low in magnesium and you start taking magnesium, you'll feel more energetic. You'll feel your muscles will really kind of react very quickly, and you'll feel good overall. Your mood will actually increase. But when it comes to vitamin D, that's not one of these supplements that's going to give you a perk. And beware of some things that do give you a perk right away, because they might actually be spinning your adrenals or artificially giving you that perk. Where, for coffee, for instance, a perfect example, stimulant, it's giving you a false sense of security when it comes to, your stimulation, and you might end up actually burning out your adrenals in a way that you don't want to. And finally, Brittany asks, I don't have the fund for blenders and juicers and dehydrators. What do I do? Don't worry about it. You don't need them. You really don't need them. I really recommend a blender, because I think that you can really get a lot of great nutrients in your foods. You can make the nutrients more accessible with a blender, but you can get a cheap blender. Our brother-in-law, he just bought a blender for a Vitamix blender. It was 1980, He bought it for $130-something. So you definitely can search around. You can find these things. I mean, it looks like a spaceship, but it does the same thing. So you can find this stuff. You can find it cheap. You can go to yard sales. I remember someone telling me that they found a Vitamix blender for $4 at an estate sale because no one knew what it was. They just wanted to get rid of it. $4. I mean, it's insane. You can't even buy, like, you know, raw cookies for $4. All right, so let's see. I just wanted to address the 30-day challenge again, guys. Please put in your applications. When we start reviewing them very soon, you're only going to have to the end of the month to put these applications in. We got it because we have to get planning and figure out where we're going to go. So get them in. The sooner the better, because we'll be looking at them very, very, very soon. And if you have a group, yes. If you have, parents, yes. If you have a family, yes. If you, your dog, sure. Whatever, but just, you know, put your applications in. We really want to hear from you guys, and plus it allows us to meet you, which is really, really, really cool. So let's help Brittany out here, guys. Your question of the day is going to be this: what deal have you got when it comes to blenders, when it comes to kitchen appliances, when it comes to getting food in bulk? Give us a tip. Tell us what you did. Tell us how you found it, and help Brittany out and everyone else who's watching, because everyone would love to save a little bit of money. So go ahead and post that down below. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.